So welcome back to the final poly class of the year. Today we'll be looking at chapters 19 and 20 of the poly primer. So these chapters introduce another word form, so past participles. And past participles are very important to be aware of because they're so common in poly. So past participles are simply taking a verb and a verb root and making it a noun or adjective. In the past tense. So in this sense, it's similar to the past tense verbs that we've already seen, but as participles, they're used as adjectives or nouns, and declined like all other adjectives and nouns. So I gave here the three most common suffixes,
as you can see.
So ha, ha, and na. So the three most common suffixes that we see. And the form one form that we'll see is using a junction vowel between the root and the suffix. And generally speaking, you'll only see this with the suffix ta. You won't see it with the other two. So a couple examples here. Again, the form is very visible. So we have the verb root, we have the junction consonant, we have the suffix ta. So pachita meaning cooked. Basita meaning spoken. So this is, again, clearly past tense. But used as a participle, then it is accordingly declined as nouns and adjectives. So pachato, pachatena, etc. Are we all on board? Pretty familiar stuff? Okay. The other form that we see is without using the connecting vowel. And in this case, if it's a root that does not end in a consonant, then it's very simple. You just stick the suffix on the end. And in those cases, again, we normally see just ta, so the ta suffix. But if there is a consonant on the consonant on the end is either dropped, as in this case, so we see gum plus ta, we just get gata. So the M has just disappeared. The M is elided, it's dropped. The other case that we see is where the consonant is assimilated to the suffix. So kipta becomes kitta. So that's kipta becoming kitta because PT is not an allowable consonant combination in poly. Very few consonant combinations are allowed in poly. Generally speaking, dissimilar consonants are always assimilated. Does that make sense?
And
okay.
Is it always assimilated in the suffix way? Like, it's never going to be kipa?
No, the suffix takes precedence.
So it's not the root?
No.
Okay.
The suffix takes precedence. And this this also then supersedes the normal consonant strength rules that we find whenever we eventually get to talking about Sunday. We'll talk about consonant strength and vowel strength. This supersedes those...
Sunday!
Sorry. Sunday means junction or joining. So Sunday... is from sung, which means together, and di, which means to hold. So sandhi literally means holding together or junction, joining. So that's when two consonants come together, then what happens? And that's the whole set of rules called sandhi. And generally speaking, what we see is consonant assimilation, as we see here. So in the other suffix that I mentioned before, so the ha suffix, here's a couple examples of that. So again, using consonant assimilation rules. Are we okay so far? Is this any questions so far? And the meaning for all of these is the same. It's all just the same past participle meaning. So past tense, used as a noun or adjective. Okay? Alright. Then feminine nouns, what's
they're
that?
All declined, right?
All declined, yes. All participles are declined like nouns and adjectives because they are nouns and adjectives. I wish there was just a single word which enclosed the meaning of both noun and adjective, since in Pali there's no distinction. Do you know one, Miss Prescriptivist Grammarian? Is there a word which encompasses the meaning both noun and adjective?
No, I have no idea.
Okay.
Substantive.
I used that one like last time, but it usually refers to an adjective functioning as a noun.
Yeah.
Which you do occasionally see in Pali. You do occasionally see adjectives which...
always see it? Because technically they're both all the time.
Yeah, I guess so.
So then they're all substantive.
Well, if we wanted to talk in that way, then you would say that every sentence contains an implied noun, and that all listed objects are in fact adjectives describing the implied noun.
Yeah.
But that seems to be going a bit far.
Well, that would make them all substantives.
Yeah. But that needlessly complicates things. So it's easier just to say that in Pali there's no distinction between nouns and adjectives. And then chapter 10 introduced a chart for feminine nouns ending in I. And if you look at this chart, you'll notice that it follows almost exactly the same pattern as for feminine nouns ending in A. So this realization was what led to the creation of my declension chart. It was the discovery that all nouns follow extremely similar patterns. Feminine nouns ending in A, the plural genitive dative ending is anam, which is basically the same as the ending for masculine nouns ending in A. So we see that both, feminine nouns ending in A, the suffix aya has instrumental, ablative, genitive, dative, or locative meanings. And with it ending in I, it's ia, and has exactly the same suite of meanings. So it's recognizing the extreme similarity between the declensions used for virtually any noun. And then we can start to connect the dots to see the patterns underneath it. So you realize that you don't actually need to memorize that many grammatical forms, because there's only a handful of grammatical forms that are used. There's only a handful of declensions and suffixes that are used. Yeah.
I did have a question about this from trying to use it on the homework. So a masculine noun ended in a long A.
Yeah.
And trying to look that up in this chart would have me believe that that could be nominative, vocative, singular, nominative, vocative, accusative, plural, or could be instrumental or ablative, singular.
Yeah.
Which is not correct.
Well, in that case, it would be dependent upon you to know, in that case, whether... like, if you recognize that this is a masculine noun, and therefore the long A must mean that it's plural, then you would already know that. If you have a way of modifying this chart to create that distinction without consuming more space than fits on one page...
Or it could be ablative singular.
Yeah.
But not instrumental.
Well, then it's time to make these distinctions
okay.
on the chart.
Okay.
I'm totally open to that.
Okay, so that's not like my misuse of or misunderstanding of the chart. It really is that the chart doesn't make that distinction.
The chart does not make such distinctions in the case of long A endings. Though your point that a long A ending cannot be instrumental, that is a good point. That means that this is in fact in the wrong place. It should be down here. It should be here with ablative singular. That's correct. Are you making note of this? You're working on an updated version of this chart.
Hey, hold on. Because, was this the same question that you had emailed?
Yeah.
So when you check Jnana Tusita's, are we talking
ablative,
masculine neuter?
I'm saying masculine noun ending in a long A.
Cannot be instrumental. It says it can be.
So
but it's one of the italic ones that's found in post-canonical, and you included all of them, so that's why that's the response.
Oh,
that
okay,
I gave.
Okay.
Oh,
okay.
I didn't read that email.
Though,
oh,
all
right.
Again, I never read post-canonical texts, which is why when he says that's only found as ablative. It's
you,
like, well, of
you,
course,
yeah.
because that's the only way you'll ever see it in the suttas.
Right. But it's technically correct.
Yeah, so that, okay, that explains why I have it listed here in that place.
Okay.
So if you wanted to get really complicated, you could have two slightly different charts, one for strictly canonical Pali and one for post-canonical Pali. I would not be opposed to that.
Yeah, so then you just...
I am not going
page.
To do it myself. But if one of you wants to do that, since you're working on an approved chart anyway, I want to see the results. I'm happy about such things happening. Anyway, so feminine nouns ending in I, it's all very familiar stuff. So I'm not going to go through it in detail. Just recognizing things like suffix ending in ing is accusative, like we used to. Ending in ia can mean almost anything. Plural, similar stuff. If it ends in he, it's plural instrumental ablative. If it ends in nung, it's plural dative genitive. If it ends in su, it's plural locative. So it's all readily identifiable things. We're all on board? Basically the same stuff we've been looking at all along. Alright, let's start looking at some examples. Starting off with a very simple one, and since... So a few ground rules before we start. First off, Devana, we already know the answers. So I would like you to pause for a few seconds before blurting out the answers so that others have a chance to say, I respect your scholastic enthusiasm, but let's make sure everyone gets a chance.
Good night.
Including
Bye.
People who have not come to the classes are still welcome to give answers if you think you have answers. So feel free to join in if you think you know something. Even if you're only vaguely certain, go ahead and say it. So let's start with this. Buddha devehi cha narehi cha pujita honti. What does this first word mean? Buddha. What does that mean?
Buddha plural.
Correct. What else could it mean?
Locative singular.
Locative singular, Buddha. You were just talking about this suffix.
Or not locative, I meant ablative.
Could be ablative singular, in which case we would have... What would it mean then?
Oh, no.
It would be
the by
from the Buddha.
From the Buddha. Yeah, if it was ablative.
Hi, nerd.
Wait, you didn't correct your because this is and I know it's going to annoy you soon.
Oh, okay. I'll go ahead and do that now.
No, it's the better one.
What, you like the squiggly N?
Yes, I like the squiggly N.
I don't like the squiggly N.
Well, too bad then.
Yeah, because I'm in charge here.
Squiggly N.
Yes.
Squiggly N is M.
Yes, and the
yes,
M with the dot is also
M with the dot is
I
yeah.
think this.
Yeah.
I like the squiggly N because it just really gave me a, like tells me how to pronounce it.
It's also, it's the same as the IPA.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well, the Pali-Roman alphabet was built on the idea that it would use only letters that are already found in English with the
dots.
Extra letters differentiated using dots and lines. So the Pali alphabet has 42 letters. The English alphabet has 26, so they made up the extra letters using dots and lines, rather than creating new characters. This was long before IPA. IPA is a very recent development.
What is IPA?
International Phonetic Alphabet.
It was an attempt to create an alphabet that could be used to describe any language in the entire world, and it almost does. It has some failings, and it has like 150 letters.
But it's pretty universally used by languages.
Anyway, let's stay focused here. We're not talking about IPA. So, devehi. Anybody who hasn't been coming to class have some guesses on this one. Devehi.
Something to do with the gods.
Something to do with devas or deities, correct? Okay.
Something to do with devas.
Ahaha. Correct. So, what's the proper grammatical term for this?
Instrumental.
Yep. Yeah, instrumental plural. And what does cha mean? Someone who hasn't been coming to class. Cha. You might know this from doing Pali chanting. And what do you think it means? Jamana? Cha means? Sunny? What does
is?
Chat mean?
With? No, I know it's not with. What do I say? That?
With is not mean.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, fine. Alex?
And.
Oh, it makes so much sense that it's and.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how about narehi?
Nara?
Go ahead.
With Nara?
It's instrumental again.
Instrumental, correct. Instrumental what? Plural? And so then, so it's instrumental plural of Nara. What does Nara mean?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Devana.
Yeah.
Oh,
oh,
man!
Oh, yeah, so with
sorry,
men.
I'll come in on the harder one.
Okay.
And?
Chat, good. How about Pujita?
Is that the feminine
of
no? Okay.
The meaning is related to puja?
Which
yeah.
Again?
Mm.
No. Does anyone know what puja means?
Offering.
Yeah. Offering, or more commonly it means like worshipping or respecting. So then pujita is...
Worship.
A...
Respected?
Past participle.
Respected?
Oh. Like said it.
Yeah, worshipped.
Oh, worship.
Okay, now here's the question. Since it's a past participle, it must be declined as a noun or adjective. So what is the declension here?
It looks like it's the same as Buddha.
Worshipped ones.
Correct. Yeah. It's the same as Buddha because Buddha and Pujita are both adjectives describing the same theoretically existing noun. Or if we wanted to say it in ordinary terms, we would say Pujita is an adjective describing Buddha. So Buddhas are worshipped, the worshipped Buddhas.
Mm.
And what is honti?
Were. No, are. No.
Yes, are. Correct. It's present tense.
Okay.
And singular or plural?
Plural.
Plural. Good.
Wait, so they're all present tense? Because I think...
Some of them are past tense. Yeah, they kind of keep you on your toes at this point.
Okay, so let's start putting this together. So at this point, I want people who have not been regularly attending class to try to put together the pieces of the sentence and tell me what it means. Keep in mind that in Pali, word order is mostly irrelevant when
worshipped
dealing with...
Buddhas are with men and devas.
No. Because instrumental can mean what? Besides with, what else can it mean?
By.
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 Yeah.
Do you have the Pali Primer link accessible?
I have the electronic version.
Okay, that's fine. Can you go to section 4 in lesson 19? Do you see the first one? It says was seen, not is seen.
Well, I think that's the meaning, but it's not literal. Literally, you would say he is seen, like the Buddha is seen.
So whenever we encounter Hopi or Honti, translated as in.
Literally, Hopi is present tense.
Okay.
Did you find a key to Pali Primer? Is that what you've been looking at?
No.
Oh, okay. Just checking. There is a key out there somewhere.
Okay.
But that's called cheating.
Like, I come to you, like...
You got awfully sheepish for a minute there.
It's just such a, like, outlandish, crazy thing. Alright.
So, yeah, literally it says... so the Buddha... I would say the Buddha who had entered the dwelling is seen by the Upasakas. Yeah, I don't know how I would translate that. I'd have to think about it, how I put that into fluent English. If you wanted to translate it as the Buddha was seen.
Ooh, what about has? Like has. Okay, there's another.
That's still past tense.
Yeah.
Let's stay focused on the exercises for now.
Okay.
And we'll deal with. We'll look at that later if it makes sense to look at it later.
Okay.
So Buddhas are worshipped by Deva and by men?
Yes, correct.
Sorry.
Okay, how did this start? The whole like finger snapping
poetry.
Yeah.
Sarah Lawrence.
Or yuppies. Or bees.
Because we talked about Sarah Lawrence.
Okay.
This is very intrusive.
Yeah.
Everything is intrusive.
Okay.
Opasika, what does this mean? What?
The one
she said that she was accused of cheating.
No.
She's gonna
I'm sorry
Rob
for accusing
for
you.
3 weeks.
Not just for tonight.
Is that the followers?
I see takes refuge somewhere.
Oh, in exchange.
Followers?
Can I translate this whole thing?
No.
Just a sentence. It's a really funny sentence.
Now your job is to practice letting go. So, disciples?
Disciples, yes, exactly.
Disciples, correct.
Disciples.
India.
Slave devotees.
We can translate it that way as well. She said disciples, so we'll go with that.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that what you said?
I said followers.
Oh, is that what you said? Okay.
Oh,
what?
Followers.
Let's translate it more literally as disciples. Upasika literally means... Literal meaning? Does anyone remember what it literally means?
Sitting next to.
Yeah. Yeah, one who sits close. Yep. Mm-hmm. How do you know these things?
Like the Upanishads.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Wow, skillman.
Linguist.
Skillman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's,
skill?
Upa, close, plus as, which means sit, plus akha, one who is. That's what it is. Okay. So, disciples, India. Iddi. Sanskrit word is siddhi.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so like finger waving, woo. Okay.
Is this like feminine?
It is.
Yeah.
It is feminine, correct?
Yay.
How do you know it's feminine?
Because I.
What?
Iya,
yeah, that's correct. Iya,
yeah.
We just saw as a feminine suffix. So what does that feminine suffix mean?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Good answer.
A lot of,
a lot of things.
Singular.
Okay. And so what does iddi mean? Go ahead, Alex or Devana.
Yeah.
What's her preferred, like, supernatural powers?
Psychic power.
Yeah.
Let's just go powers.
Powers.
Is it singular or plural?
Singular.
Okay.
Love
yeah,
things.
In my notes I just put blank for like the a lot of, for any of the ya endings. I was just like...
Well, let's go with spiritual power for iddi.
Mm. Okay.
It can also mean success, by the way. I don't... Does she mention that possible meaning?
No.
Iddi can just mean success or successful. And there's one sutta in particular where there's a pun off that, where a monk was going to go and give a Dhamma talk to the nuns, and the nuns were like, oh, him again? He always just says the same boring stuff. This is not going to be a successful talk. And he comes and he gives the same boring ass talk, and they're just like, that was not a successful talk. And then word gets back to the monk, and he's going back the next day again, and they're like, oh God, not him again. It still won't be successful. And then he gets there and he levitates up in the air while giving the talk. The nuns were like, oh, now it's successful. And the pun here is that successful also means by means of psychic powers. Anyway. I'm glad one person laughed about this. It's a lot funnier when you're reading it in Pali.
It's in the canon?
Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
There's a lot of puns in the Pali which you will never see in translation because they just do not translate.
Laughing at some of the like outlandish, like crazy remarks, and it's like there's so much humor in it. It's wasted.
No, it's packed. Now the Pali humor, the Pali canon is packed with like really dry humor. It's everywhere.
There's a book, Humor in the Pali Canon, by Thomas Alvitur.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. He analyzes the various forms
Ooh.
Of the dry humor.
Because
I'm interested in this.
Nothing makes humor funnier
Alex.
Like analyzing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Smiles.
Focus.
Is that
Akase.
House?
No. Akase. Okay.
Just
go for it. first off, okay.
Can I have gestures?
Go ahead.
So, in on at the sky, I would say.
Okay, what else can it mean besides sky?
Heaven?
No.
Shion.
Space.
Okay. Oh.
That's the way it's more commonly used, actually, is like the. Akasa Nancha Yatanam, the dimension of infinite space. Or Akasa Dhatu, the space element. So sky is not sufficient in those cases, it has to be space. So when I see Akasa, I think space.
It's funny, it's not like Tian in Chinese. That's what you were thinking of.
Yeah, totally, that's
so,
what I was thinking of.
Gachantang. Focus, Chibana, you know this one.
Close for a refuge.
Close! Close! Yeah, we know that the root gach means go,
mm-hmm.
So then what is the form?
Oh, mm-hmm. Then?
Present participle?
Yes!
Yes!
Yeah.
Present participle,
going,
correct. And what is the declension here?
Well, it's the same as tapasan.
Correct.
So I'm gonna guess it's modifying that noun.
We can go with that, yeah. And what's the declension?
Accusative singular.
Okay. And tapasan means what? You might know this one, Skillman. Tapasan. That has nothing to do with appetizers.
I was thinking.
He preempted your choice.
Traits?
No. Alex?
I don't remember. It's
yeah, it's not. I remember it actually. No, it's
is
different.
Like she translates as hermit.
Ascetic. It means ascetic. She's just wrong.
Yeah. Well, same thing. Hermit, ascetic.
No.
I could be an ascetic right here and not be a hermit. And I can be a hermit and not be an ascetic. They're not the same thing at all.
Okay,
ascetic.
Great, I win.
I don't think that was true. What's that?
Accusative singular.
Did you just make fun of the colons?
Yeah.
I happen to like colons. And I will continue using colons. So, disva,
yes.
What's this? What is disva?
Absolutive.
Correct. Absolutive meaning what? Somebody want to have a stab at this one?
Should know this, but I don't.
Giovanna?
Eyesight?
Close.
Looks?
And, but it's the absolutive of looks, which is?
The looking?
That
having
the
blank.
Or that be the germ?
Having blank.
Yes, except we're using the word absolutive instead of gerund for whatever reason. You'll see
looking?
It both ways. But yeah, it means having done something or after doing something. So disva would mean having looked or after looking.
Oh, it means staring.
Oh, like the ablative absolute
mm-hmm.
in Latin.
Whatever he said
yes.
is, that might be true. Okay,
yeah.
So.
Gerundio.
Yeah.
Yeah, gerundio.
that's stones?
No, you're close, but no. You're thinking of, is it Pasana?
Pasada.
No,
oh,
for
oh,
stone.
Pasana.
Stone,
mm-hmm.
I think, is Pasana. Anyway, different word.
Ajahn Pasano?
That's not his, this is his name. His name, this is Ajahn Pasano, this is his name.
Oh,
every, about once a year at Abhayagiri, he would tell people how to say his name correctly, and then everyone would immediately forget and go back to calling him Pasano. Once a year, he would say, Pa-san-no. One S, two N's. Pa-san-no. And then the next day, people would go back to calling him Pa-san-no, which is
Pa-san-no.
Not correct.
Which
oh,
means
I call him properly then. Ajahn Pa-san-no.
Yeah, that's almost correct.
Actually, yeah.
Italian, in Bali,
R,
best friend.
So, what does Pa-san-no mean?
It's
Something good, probably.
Yeah.
I thought it meant stone, that's why I'm so amused.
No. No, he's not the stoned one. What's that?
I haven't met him. Is he his name?
It depends on how she translates it.
Oh.
She does
it's,
not.
Is pleased with.
The one that was pleased?
No. Pasan, no, no. Pasana means like filled with faith. It can mean either filled with faith or filled with joy, or it can mean clear, or it can mean yeah, like clear-minded. These are its three meanings. Pleased is not one.
Vipassana, like
Vipassana.
You said filled with clear.
Vipassana is from.
Vipass.
Yeah, from the root pas, which means to see.
Mm.
That's what it's from. So vipassana means, the prefix vi has many meanings, which I won't go into here, but in this case, the meaning is probably distinct. So it means distinctly seeing. So that's how I translate it. Yeah.
Have a joy. That's nice.
And Honti, we already saw, so I won't. Yeah. Okay, so let's stick all this together. You want to translate this? Go for it.
But you didn't put the whole faith joy. You just put the noun.
I ran out of space. So go ahead. What does this mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just because I want your forgiveness for whatever I did that upset you. I already
don't
forgot.
Remember.
Oh, that's good.
Having seen the aesthetic going into space by means of his or her supernatural power, disciples are filled with joy. Or faith, or whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
Joy, or face, or whatever.
Yeah. Exactly.
The next translation.
In this case, I'd probably, instead of saying going into the sky, because that would, in that case, we'd use accusative. So locative probably means in, and that like they're going in space.
Oh.
Through space would also make sense.
Yeah, through is instrumental.
Yeah.
So wait.
But it's also can be like the location of an action. So locative indicating the location where something's happening. So like they're moving around in space.
So like throughout, maybe.
Through
that
English
still implies
means, basically is what he's saying, right? Like through can mean through means of or through the location of.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so in this case it's location. It's just saying like they're moving in space. So you might say they're moving through the sky, or you might say they're moving in the sky. And either way, it'd be, you don't like it, do you?
It doesn't sound very Englishy.
Well,
okay.
That's because it's not English, it's Pali. So you'll notice some minor differences in how some things are used like that.
So they're not going into the space, they're just going in space?
That's why I would translate this.
Okay.
Yep.
They're just floating around.
Yeah, they could just be floating around.
Or they could just be, you know, walking around.
Oh, that sounds great.
Okay, then let's move on to the great one.
Yeah.
Instead of lingering on the boring ones about people levitating.
Like powers.
Yeah. So, ahung. Who remembers what ahung means?
I?
Yes!
Yay, I remember stuff.
Pariye sitang. Do you remember this one as well?
No.
Jabana?
Why me?
Because you've come to about half these classes.
Without ever studying.
Yeah.
Searched.
Correct. It is what form?
That would be a past participle declined in the accusative singular.
Correct. And so how can you tell it's a past participle?
Eat.
Yep. So we have the I, the connecting vowel, and the ta, the suffix. And then it's declined as a noun or adjective. Got that? Do you understand? Okay.
This one's probably better translated as stop.
Having school, having search.
Yeah, searched for, sought for, sought out. We'll come to that, as long as we all agree with what it means. And what does dhammang mean?
The dhamma.
Correct, and what is the declension?
Accusative singular.
Yes!
It's like you've been here all along.
He
yes,
has been.
Human, you really should come to these things.
Well,
you can even drive.
He might be using his iffy invisibility.
He had a car, honey.
So focus, we're not here to talk about cars, we're here to talk about Pali. Adigantwa, what is the declension? First off, Adigantwa, what's the declension?
Understand.
I asked for the declension, not for the
meaning. Wait, it's still applicable.
Twa. Gerund?
Yes.
Ha.
Which
understanding.
Which means?
Understanding.
No.
Having understood?
Yes.
Having
Now, I don't like understood as a definition of adigantwa, so we'll talk about that in a second. First off, modami. Modami.
I
did something. She translates it.
Correct. I did something. That's correct. And let me guess, she gives some horrendous mistranslation of this
word. I don't know, but take the light.
Oh, that's correct, actually.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's from the same root as mudita. So they're both from the root mud, which is not pronounced like mud. I don't know why I just lost formatting. Mud means like joy or delight. And so from that we get mudita. It's also where we get anumodana, from that same root, and other such related words. So modami means I delight, or take joy in. So adigantwa is adi, which means high or heightened or superior, plus gam, which means to go to or reach. Go to is more common, go, that's hard. So what she's translating is understood is like you've completely gone to something. You've arrived at it in its highest sense. So then the applied meaning can be understood. But just so we're clear on the pieces of this word.
Or attained.
Yeah, you could put it that way as well. Attained. So, Giovanna, what is this sentence saying?
Listen.
Yeah.
It's too simple.
No.
See, it's because you're struggling to mangle it and you can't. Nice.
I volunteer.
Go for it.
I delight having attained the sought out dawn.
Correct.
Wow.
Correct. You're really good at this. Are you sure you haven't been coming?
Yes.
Okay.
I when I see your live streams, I like them on Facebook. I don't watch, I just like.
I didn't realize how powerful likes were. Okay, let's look at this next one. Sabayam does not mean with fear. Sabayam. With fear would be sabaya, which is not what this is. So, sabayam. Anyone have any guesses to the declension to begin with?
Accusative singular?
No.
Have a look here. It ends in young. Where do we see young? Here's one place where we see young.
Yeah.
Locative, feminine. That's one place we see young. Do we see it anywhere else?
Ayam?
We don't, but the other possibility is that sabaya is the whole word, and then the suffix is just mm. That's another possibility. Just putting out some possibilities here.
Is that accusative singular?
That's one possibility.
Yeah.
If there was a word sabaya,
yeah.
Have we encountered a word sabaya so far? I'll give you a hint. There is no such word.
Okay.
The word is?
Sabha.
Sabha. That is the word. So we know the suffix is yang, which we just discovered can only be locative feminine. So we know it's locative feminine. And what does sabha mean? Assembly hall.
Oh, the hall, not the people.
No, not the people.
In the people.
They could have sat on the people. So,
well,
nisi ditva, what does this mean?
You could be like among the assembly,
having
for example.
That is true. That's true. Among the assembly. Could be. Yeah, sabha means assembly hall, the location of assembly.
Ah, okay.
It's
so
a physical place.
So then,
having sat?
Yeah.
Correct. Having sat what?
I don't know. She only told me sat.
Having sat down. The prefix nit means down.
Or having sat in your floated position.
I'm going to ignore that statement to move on. So, dharakaya. Dharakaya. First off, what's the declension here?
Aya.
Correct. Which can mean virtually anything. So what is dharika?
Girl.
Yes.
Singular.
Singular girl. So a singular girl is doing something unknown so far. So unknown declension. Gayatang.
Tang.
What did we want Sunny to do at the end of the retreat?
Sandy?
Correct. So what is gayatang?
Chang.
Some.
Close.
Singing.
Singing.
You've got the wrong kind of participle.
It's just some.
Oh.
Having
yeah,
some.
Past. It's a past participle.
What?
Some.
It hung.
Accuser of singing?
Correct. Yep.
So
yeah, so we
like
have...
close and not right.
because you said having...
absolutely.
Exactly so.
Oh, okay.
Whereas this is the past participle, so it's just some yeah. being used as an adjective.
So the sun.
Like the sun being the sun.
Yeah.
So what is gi tang? This should be very easy.
Song.
Yes. Correct.
Oh, is that when Gita comes from Gaya?
Well,
Gita?
We... yeah, we talked about this in
the
a previous
thing,
class.
Sun, yeah.
Vowel strengthening.
Okay.
I goes to... E goes to, oh god,
E.
My mind is blanking. E?
Yeah,
E. No, Aya. E and then Aya? Is that right?
I think so. I thought there was an E in there somewhere.
Gi, ge, gaya. Do you have the notes? I have to dig them up.
I'd have to dig them up as well, I'm sorry.
I don't have it open right now. I'm going to find it though because this is a project.
I'll see who's faster. Okay, I becomes E becomes Aya.
Which?
We
which
were talking about lesson 12 or 13.
Okay, yeah, I becomes E becomes Aya. There we go.
So not long IE, but E.
Yeah.
So then, from the root, which is either gi or gi, I don't remember off the top of my head, probably gi. Gi, then we can get ge, which I haven't actually seen anywhere, but it's theoretically possible. And gaya. So they're both from the same root, which means singing.
This is gai, G-A-I is the root.
G-A-I. G-A-I is the root?
That's what.
That has to be Sanskrit.
Oh.
I don't have any truck with Sanskrit roots. I only do Pali roots. Yeah. She's fired.
So why don't we continue in April? No more Zola.
Well, we might as well finish Pali Primer because we're more than halfway through.
Right.
We could switch to a different book if people want to. We'll talk about it another time. There's another book which is much better, but you have to already have a base of understanding or else you can't get started.
That's great.
Yeah, exactly. So, continuing. Sutva.
Having
Javana.
Heard. Oh, sorry.
Having heard.
Very good! Kanyayo, Giovanna.
No, you said Giovanna.
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 Okay, Kanyayo, Giovanna.
It's girls, but it's different from Darikaya.
Correct. And that is actually useful in this sentence.
Yeah.
And what is the declension of Kanyayo? Most likely correct. Mo Ding Su, Giovanna. We just saw the same verb in a different form. Delight, correct. And so what's the Ing Su suffix? What does that indicate?
Delighted.
Delighted, correct. How many people delighted? One or many?
Many.
Yes, many. Excellent.
Come on, this is great for Giovanna.
Okay.
Suk song. Delighted the girls. In an assembly.
Yeah!
This is what we
have. Well done.
No, having sat down on a girl. Sorry, I forgot the other girl.
Darikaya could be locative.
It could be, actually.
It could be locative, yeah.
That gives a very different meaning to the sentence. I don't think that's what's going on. Skillman, do you want to have a more serious guess?
The girls delighted having heard the sung song in the assembly hall. Also, they sat down.
That's getting closer. So I'll give you a freebie here. So this clause you want to put before anything else in the sentence.
Oh, like in ablative apps.
Yeah. Is
having sat down in the assembly hall.
Good.
Yeah, the girls delighted having heard the other girls sing the sung song.
Close. Having heard the song sung
by
the girl. Correct. It's in this case, it's being used in an instrumental sense. Yep. Good.
I like my version better.
Yours was certainly more amusing. Okay, let's move on. Sache, Giovanna. Oh. I'm just going to ask Giovanna every time. Rupalo. Giovanna?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, I remove everything because I'm not, I haven't decided to study Pali, so my brain does not
retain
information.
Am I, by the way, am I included in the video? Like, is my face visible in the video?
No
your head is.
just this part.
So, my facial expressions are not visible.
Correct.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay, okay.
Should we even have told you that?
Well, yeah, because now I can use facial expressions, which I don't want to be seen on Facebook. Okay, Bhupala.
Sevala?
It does not mean Devana.
What? Okay.
Singular? Correct? Singular what? It is a singular noun. Nominative? Singular nominative? Good. What does it mean? Okay, anyone can answer at this point.
King!
Yay!
Oh!
How about Dhamma?
With
the
Dhamma.
Yes!
Yay.
Yes! With Dhamma? With Dhamma or?
Hands.
Teaching?
Or in accordance with Dhamma.
Oh, right.
How about Manusse, Giovanna?
The people.
What declension could this be? Be at least two things.
Plural accusative.
Or?
Locative singular.
Okay.
In on F.
So, which one do we think it probably is?
In on F.
Sitting on the human.
On the human. Protecting all over them.
No, your first statement was better. So, accusative plural. Rakteya. What's going on here?
Aya.
Aya, correct. What does Aya signify? Optative, good. Optative what?
Was that in your chat? I saw that.
It is on the chart. Let's have a look at the chart.
Third person singular?
Yep, that's right here. Optative is a plus the optative ending, which here is a, third person singular.
So there's no subjunctive, just optative?
Yeah.
I don't have any clue what subjunctive means, which
no,
means it's probably
no
not used in poly.
What's optative?
Optative indicates possibility, something that might happen. Like it
so
sounds like option. Optative, option.
Yes.
Something
there's
which might happen.
Conditional,
but we haven't done it.
Conditional is a bit different. We'll come across that later. Though optative is sometimes used similar to conditional.
It's like would that.
Yeah.
Optative is like would,
might.
Could, may,
oh, yeah.
Might.
Hypothetical.
Yeah. Though conditional is also used for hypotheticals. Anyway, we'll cover conditional when
but
we get to it.
Conditional is used for conditions.
Yeah. Conditional is most often used for a hypothetical which the speaker believes to be untrue or extremely unlikely.
And it's used in, like, longer constructions. And the optative is just in the verb, right?
I can't comment on that. Anyway, rakeya, let's just look at this, rakeya. So we know it's optative, third person singular.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the verb itself mean?
Rakeya.
Alex?
Protect.
Yes, so putting it all together, rakeya means?
Might protect.
She might protect.
It might protect, okay. Te can mean many things, but what's the simplest meaning of te?
The?
No,
sounds like te.
Him?
Sounds like te.
Sounds, yeah, it sounds very similar to what it means in English.
The?
They.
They, correct.
Oh.
Te means they. It can mean several other things. As you look at the chart, you can see te can mean many things. But most commonly, te is nominative third person plural, they. It has other meanings, so second person singular.
It wasn't far off when I was thinking y'all.
Yeah.
But it's not the right person.
Yeah. Close though. Kamani, Giovanna.
Karma.
Yes.
Yes. And what's the declension?
Many karmas.
Many karmas. Yes. And
many
what does karma
karmas.
Mean? What does karma mean?
Action.
Yay! See, you're learning poly. Don't you feel happy?
Katva. Actions?
Yeah.
Having acted?
Yes! Having done, or having performed, or having acted. Yep. Okay. And continuing the sentence, dareke.
Can you use sache with the, indicative?
No, the optative is the I thought you meant imperative.
No.
It has to go
if,
with the optative.
Yeah, if would not go with indicative. I wouldn't. No, you would not see that.
Right.
If has to go with optative or conditional. Yep. So darake, what is this?
Children.
Children, correct. What's the declension?
Plural accusative.
All right.
Probably not locative.
Probably not locative, though we can keep that in mind when translating. I'm sure Giovanna would have a field
you
day with that
it
one.
In parentheses just so she has it.
She'll find other ways to mingle the sentence. Posenta. First
present
off,
participle.
What's present participle, correct?
Plural. Maybe. Maybe not. I was going to say plural nominative.
Right.
Could be. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that would make a fair amount of sense. And what does the word mean? Devana?
Nourishing or looking after?
Yeah.
Looking after.
Caring.
Supporting, raising, caring for. Let's say supporting.
Yeah.
Sukhang, Giovanna, you know this one. Sukhang. It's the opposite of dukkham. What is dukkha? You have a lot of it right now, apparently.
Satisfaction?
What's the opposite of dukkha?
not being a Dalai Glass.
Satisfaction?
Yes. It means like pleasure or satisfaction.
Apparently Gio couldn't get no.
Okay. Actually, let's go with satisfaction. That's cute in this case. Vindayang. Has nothing to do with vindictive. Vindayang. Vindayung.
Wine?
Yeah.
Vindayung. Nothing to do with wine either. First off, what's the case?
Optative.
Optative, correct. Distinct optative infix. Giovanna, you recognize this infix, of course.
Yeah.
Indicates optative.
Yeah.
And ung, ayung, ung, what does that signify?
Third person plural.
Correct. So
they might.
They might what? I'll point out a connection in English that makes this very easy to remember.
Might find?
That's not. She translates it as
feel
experience.
Yeah. That's what she has.
No.
Correct.
No.
Okay,
it's fine.
Experience.
It's fine.
Fine.
Yeah. In fact, I believe it is cognate with find. As with so many polyglots.
Indo-European
words. Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of Indo-European roots where you'll look at a poly word and it'll resemble its meaning because they're related.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I would translate vindayum as they might find, which still makes perfect sense in this sentence. It doesn't change the meaning of the sentence. So, yeah, Dr. Da Silva is fired. Fired. So, Giovanna. Giovanna, here's
the
your
shine.
Chance.
It can't be recorded.
Oh.
Is this going to be a Me Too scenario?
Let's say it's better if I don't troll this sentence.
Oh my god.
I don't even want
to. So what's the case of Da? Okay.
Oh, Dawarke, what's it? What's the case?
Accusative
plural. So it indicates what something is happening to.
Same with Mandus.
Yeah.
And Giovanna's not gonna do it.
Okay, I think Skillman.
You can put a comma after tech, and that'll be make it easy.
Yeah. This will help you a little bit.
Yeah, if a king protects people with dhamma, they would find action. They would find satisfaction supporting children having performed actions. Performed actions supporting children.
Yeah,
they
that's
were
good.
Satisfied.
That's good.
Why? What does children have to do with king and dama?
Well, because if the king is protecting the people in accordance
with
dama,
and the people protect the kids, or something like that, right?
So
yeah,
trickle down.
Is this more in accordance with dama?
Yeah,
as opposed to with the dama,
Yeah, dhammena normally means in accordance with dhamma. That's normally how it's used.
So, here's my question.
I want to hear Giovanna's version now.
Mm-hmm.
We'll ask you after the recording is off.
So here's my question. Bupalo is singular, and
correct.
Te is plural. So, is Bupalo and Te referring to the same subject?
No, as I see it, so Te is a new one, which we presume is talking about the same humans the king is protecting. But it's not the same declension. So this is technically a new actor for the subsequent sentence.
You mean
so if the grammarian would probably insist that we actually have a period here. Or possibly a semicolon.
Very funny, Bonte.
Sorry,
oh, well, okay, fine.
No! The pain of medicine.
Just put them all together.
Oh my god, please stop. This looks like an emoji now.
What's your question?
Can kama or kamani mean good deeds? Like, can it be implicit good deeds?
No. No. In fact, there's one. In some contexts, kama has the implicit meaning of torture,
oh,
like
okay.
performing torture, which is not the case here. Before Giovanna runs with that one. It's like, there's suttas, could you pass me that? The suttas where it says like, they take the criminal to the king, and the king has various kamas performed, such as scalping and
so
on.
It can have a negative connotation or a neutral connotation.
No, I think positive.
It's just neutral. It's just neutral. Its meaning just means action.
If you explicate that it has a positive connotation.
It
well,
has whatever connotation you give to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, exactly.
So
then it doesn't have a connotation if you have to.
Yeah, it has whatever connotation the context gives to it. So it's like tofu. It just absorbs the flavor of whatever's around it.
The Greek word for experience has a negative connotation unless you explicate.
Okay. Interestingly enough, the Pali word for feeling, vedana, in some contexts, it clearly means unpleasant feeling. So, like in the case of the meal chant, for example, it just says vedana, but the meaning is clearly unpleasant feeling. Otherwise, it doesn't make any sense.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a number of cases where vedana has that sense, but not kama. Kama is just neutral.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, moving on. Pani yang pivitva dharakaya bhuni yang nikito patobin no hoti.
Dharaka is girl.
This is a very sad story right here. Dharaka is in fact girl, but let's take this one word at a time. Pani yang. Pani yang.
Hey, what you got there, Bhante?
This just might be. So. Pani yang pivitva.
Oh.
Having drunk
water.
Yes, correct. And pani yang is a fun word that I'm going to pull out a little bit more. It's a form which we haven't seen yet, which is future passive participle, which indicates a injunction. So
that which is drinkable.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Paniyang literally means drinkable.
Potable.
So that if you look at the declension chart, future passive participle, aniya, well, there's many different forms, unfortunately, but aniya is the form that we're seeing here. So, aniya or aniya, these suffixes indicate to be done. So, those who are familiar with the Karaniya Metta Sutta know that that means what's to be done.
So it implies like you should do it.
I don't personally like the word should, but it's sometimes translated that way, like this is what should be done.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's translated that way. I don't like that because that implies a command.
Is
Whereas it's more just saying like, if you want this, this is what is to be done.
It's more like a list,
it's
like a to-do list.
Yeah, it's more like a to-do list. But it can also indicate possibility, so like something that can be done. So in this case, paniya means something that you can drink. It's possible to drink it. So paniyang is a beverage, more literally. So it's used as water, but literally beverage would be more accurate.
Mm.
Something that is drinkable. So the connotation is water, but realistically any beverage is fine.
As long as it's drinkable.
As long as it's drinkable.
Deka might be able to be drunk. But
yeah.
Not necessarily.
Yeah, Utica is specifically water. Okay, so Davrakaya, you said, means girl. What's the declension?
All of them.
So something about a girl. Boom Myung. Alex?
On the ground.
On the ground, excellent. On, at, in, ground. Nick Hitto. Yeah, ground, earth. Earth would also be accurate here. Nikito.
It's nominative.
Cool.
It is nominative, correct?
So he has both puts down or throws away, and Alex and I both went different routes of translation, which is exciting.
So nit means down, and kipati means to throw.
Oh.
So it is throw. It is through down.
I could toss.
Toss
down.
I don't think so.
Threw it on the ground.
Threw
just like, throw down, girl.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I don't think that's how it's been used. So, I also don't know where that accent came from. Patto, patto. What is a patto?
Yes.
Also
yeah.
Also,
a boy?
Bo.
No,
bo.
Oh, bo. Yeah. Oh, makes sense.
What is binno? What happens if you throw your bowl down on the ground?
Shards.
Close. More generic.
Broken.
Broken, correct. And hoti?
Present arm.
Yep. But it's singular. Yeah, it is. Okay, Giovanna.
So,
yes.
What would
it's
the
time to answer, like, put the sentence together.
So, Nikito, if it were, like, being left, would it be need?
Sorry?
Because nikamati is like leaves, discards, renounces.
Yeah, that's like if you're leaving something behind.
Yeah, so what would be the past participle of that?
I would probably expect something like that. Nikamata. Probably what you'd expect to see.
So how come Nikipati like can just get rid of the P and Nikamati can't get rid of it then?
Nikipati. Nik Kipta equals Nikita. So Nikamati. What I would Nikamata. Oh, well, no, you wouldn't see Nikanta because that's the present participle form. So you would not see that.
Mm-hmm.
If you saw it in this form, you would see that, but I've never seen that.
Mm-hmm.
Never seen it.
Also, you're combining stops in the latter case, and in the former case, you're combining a nasal consonant
so
in the stop.
Yeah, but
so
what would it be?
Stops.
That's my question.
What's that?
What would it be?
It would be Nikamata. That would be the present participle, or the past participle form. That's what you'd see.
Hmm.
That's what you'll see in the suttas anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't. They might have invented other forms in later centuries, but that's what you'll see in the suttas. So, Giovanna, what is this sentence?
Have drunk the beverage. They threw down the girl in the earth with a broken bowl.
About having drunk the girl in the earth.
I know, I was also tempted to do that.
The drunk girl in the earth threw down the beverage on the broken bowl.
Yeah.
Okay, what is this really saying?
Having drunk the beverage, the girl threw the bowl on the ground. It's broken.
That's getting closer. Does someone else want to try?
I will. The bowl thrown on the ground by the girl who drank was broken.
What?
Aspect?
Or is broken.
No, I don't like
having
that.
Having drunk beverage, the girl threw down the broken bowl on the ground.
Yes!
Yeah.
Yes!
Actually?
Yes,
no, no, no,
correct.
No.
Why would it be broken before she threw it?
Because
that's what's
she
written here.
Threw down is not possible. It's not the main verb.
Oh.
Yeah, so the bowl
is broken.
The
is
the
right. The bowl,
so
the
bowl
is
broken by the girl.
Mm-hmm.
It is thrown down on the ground by the girl. I see your point. Okay.
The bowl is,
go
yeah.
for it.
So the bowl thrown down on the ground by the girl after drinking her beverage is broken.
Okay. Yeah, I don't like what De Silva's doing here of using the present tense indicative to indicate past actions. I don't like that. I do not like that.
That's why the bee was broken.
Yeah. Yeah, this is... Yeah, I do not like that. That is... Okay, moving on. Let's start pulling apart another one.
King.
The king!
Namrata.
Yes. How about this one? Rajaniya.
Reigning?
With the queen.
With the queen. Rajani? They're translating Rajani as queen?
Yeah, that's how they're translating it.
Well, that's
like
fine, but you just don't normally see Rajani as queen. Normally you would see Devi in the suttas. You don't normally see Rajani, you see Devi.
They have them both listed. But
oh, okay.
Princess?
No, Rajani just means female ruler. But my point is that you don't see that.
Like
so
that.
It's a feminine form of Raja, which means king.
Is it?
No.
So what's the difference between
like
both Palo and Raja?
Yeah, do they have Raja?
Yes. Yeah, I mean, properly speaking, the Pali word is Rajan, which we haven't come to yet because we don't know that declension form.
When you said Rajakumara, that was the only way that I knew what you were saying.
Yeah, so Rajani, in my mind, that's a theoretical form because I haven't seen it in the suttas anywhere. So theoretically possible, but I haven't seen it.
But what's the difference between Bhupala and Raja?
Bhupala literally means?
Being that protects?
No.
The ground protector.
Protector of beings. Or protector of the ground, protector of the earth. It can mean either protector of beings or protector of the earth.
Does one outrank the other?
What's that?
Does one outrank the other?
King fired.
Bupa?
No, they just mean king. They just mean king. There's not a ranking there. So Rajaniya we have as queen. What's the declension?
With.
Possibly with. Or it could be...
Sanking
this
with.
Ah, clever. With queen. It's getting late. With queen. Navaya. Could be... you're
men?
Close. You're thinking... Nava means new. But Nava means...
Ship.
Boat.
Ship.
Boat. Like navigating.
Mm-hmm.
And properly speaking...
Navigate.
It's Nava because it's feminine. Mm.
So
what's
blank,
the difference?
Something.
So something involving a boat.
All of the things.
What?
All of Aya.
Because it's Aya. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. Nadine, what's a Nadine? Nadine.
River.
Toronto.
Yeah.
It's not a city
like
in Ontario. Flowing? Yeah. No, I'm thinking of a different word.
Crossing.
Crossing.
Water.
Okay, water. And what's the declension?
What was the different word you were thinking of?
Let's not get confused here. It's a word that hasn't been brought up yet in the book.
It would be a discriminatum.
In
what?
The water.
In the water? That sounds reasonable. In
or
on
after.
Charante. What is Charante? Charante. that's cute. But let's be a bit more literal.
Wandering, roaming?
Wandering, roaming, yeah. Charity, the root char just means to conduct oneself. So it's quite broad in how it can possibly be used.
Yeah.
In this sentence, I like meandering.
Okay, we'll go with meandering. You're right. I'm feeling indulgent right now.
Rivers meander.
Mm-hmm.
How about mache? No. Fish, what's the declension?
Plural accusative.
Quite possible. What's olo kento?
Olo kento.
Good, good.
Oh, it is looking, just the O moves to the front.
Yeah. Oh, looking at that. Okay, amachehi.
Is it related to the fish?
Yeah. Oh, wait.
With ministers.
Oh, wait, no. Spelling is a little different.
Sadding.
Yeah, because the roots are so close, you have to really pay attention.
Great. And cut candy.
You'll
get confused quick that way. Kateti.
Speaks.
It speaks.
What's the difference between basati and kateti?
Basati and kateti?
Yeah.
Kateti tends to have more the implication of conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas basati, you might be basatiing by yourself. I know, we all like to pretend we don't talk to ourselves, but we all do when we think we're alone.
Nobody talks about it.
I don't talk to myself.
Sure you don't.
No.
Oh, sure you don't.
Yeah, sure.
I just don't.
Yeah, that's what you think, except when you do.
What are you
doing
actually, we're all talking
to ourselves right now. Really?
Okay. Technically true. So, Giovanna, what does this one say?
The king. Well, I don't know. That was fire.
Something about fish looking at the ministers.
Yeah. Not
okay.
Not
okay. Somebody want to really translate this then? Drager.
The king speaks with the queen.
What is the sentence saying?
Oh, let's see.
This is the sentence. What's going on here?
King with queen with question mark boat river crossing. Yeah.
Meandering fish looking at
it speaks. The king. The king. Crossing the river with the queen,
on a boat, with the ministers,
looking at meandering fish speaks.
You're pretty close.
Or the meandering fish are speaking?
No. So you were totally good on the first part here. So the king is crossing the river using a boat along with his queen, and the king.
No, Olokento, yeah.
Yeah, the king who is. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Oh, okay. So the king crossing the river by boat with the queen, and looking at the meandering fish in the water is. Or speaks with his minister.
Correct. Excellent. Okay, it's 5 to 9.
Speaks with his minister.
Were there any remaining questions from other things to be brought up before we wrap up for the evening? Otherwise, we could just finish off these last few exercises. In close examined detail. We can analyze the detail of every one of these remaining bits.
There. There are two that, or how
lesson 20 number 10, was that one of the ones?
No.
If there's specific ones you want to look at, just go ahead and yell them out and I'll find them. And
okay,
we'll
so lesson 20, number 12, and lesson...
Let's see, 2012. Oh, 2012, I remember that. Yeah, the world did not end.
Oh boy.
Oh, this was
much
supposed
like
to that.
Wait,
but
let's face
yeah.
them all and we'll do Alex's first.
Okay, so
and
this
then
one.
Number 10.
Nine.
So we're looking at it right here. So
oh.
this is which one? Exercise 20, number 12. So let's go ahead. What's your question? Oh, yeah, we'll go with the squigglies for now.
Whoa.
We'll leave the squigglies.
What squigglies? Yay, squigglies!
Yeah, we've got the squiggly N that you like. See, squiggly N. So, what's the question?
It wasn't. It's a funky one to translate, so.
Okay.
The question was,
which, was there one
Karitva.
That you
had?
Charitva.
Karitva.
In that
sentence.
Oh, Karitva. Having done.
Having
oh, it
done?
Is done.
Yeah. It's
okay.
just a different form. We used to sing Katva, but Karitva is also perfectly acceptable.
Oh, I
same
thought
meaning.
It might be having bought, because in this sentence that makes much more sense.
Is it something about a king and minister and like no one?
No, it doesn't mean bought. It mean
could
having
it mean having made?
Having made, yeah.
Oh, okay. Then it makes sense again. Because he's making calls.
Yeah.
Salah.
Yeah, having made.
Village doing king.
Yeah, having made halls in the village. Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
What would the gerund be then for bought, having bought?
What's the verb? Vikanati, I think.
No.
Kanati.
Kanati?
Yes.
No H?
Except no H.
No.
Yeah.
Kanati?
Mm-hmm.
What are you asking for? Which form?
Gerund.
You might see Kinitva. That's what I would expect.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That would be more straightforward.
Okay,
thank you.
Should I just give my thing and you can tell me before?
For which one? This sentence?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Okay. The good minister informed the king after making, I guess, the halls in the villages to live in for the beggars after spending their wealth.
That's not what I have.
But I didn't, so I put the absolutive with the beggars.
No.
So here's what I have.
Yeah, what do you have?
The good minister having, or the good man, the minister, having spent wealth making halls in the villages for the beggars to dwell in,
mm-hmm.
informed the king what he had done.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Better,
yeah, that's good.
And there's a kitty. Hi, kitty.
Okay. Yep. And you had another one you wanted to look at?
Number 10?
Then we should wrap up for the night. Number 10 of which exercise?
20.
Okay.
Or did you want to do 20 on number 19 instead?
Oh, that's okay.
That one was also a question I wanted to ask, so if you wanted to ask that one too.
I did want
to
ask that.
Okay, yeah, let's do number 20 on 19 instead.
With
something. Yes, but you wanted to look at a different one.
Sorry.
We both wanted to look at the same.
Which one?
Number...
Which one?
20 on lesson
19.
Yeah.
Let me have a look here.
Oh,
19.
Man, that
one
is... Oh, because of... This was the one I asked you about in the Valentine room this afternoon.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that cha at the end is just like, what?
Yeah.
Okay, 1 second. Let me pull this one up. Okay. We'll just go with one of these, we don't need both. What's the problem?
So.
What about
it? So far we've been translating it as an.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, how would you translate this
go
sentence?
Go ahead and translate the sentence, and then when you run into a problem, we'll handle the problem.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Having given little to the beggar who is oppressed with hunger, from the rice prepared, I don't know, for her daughter, the woman gave water, so we could as well, but... So before I had, the woman gave from the rice prepared with her daughter.
How about just, the way we translate this fluently is, she gave a little from the rice and she gave water.
But there's so much
She gave
that.
A little
yeah,
of the rice and she gave water.
But
so.
But then how would you put in to the beggar who's oppressed with hunger?
Or after she gave a little of the rice, then she gave water. So that's using chun in a slightly, again, Disselba kind of mangled this sentence, which is terribly sad.
And
this is one reason why I wanted to switch to the other book, is because the other book uses actual sutta quotes.
Mm-hmm.
So not made up sentences, uses actual sutta
yeah,
extracts.
Yeah,
but amha,
it just seems...
Amha, isn't that from?
Yeah, it's from.
So she took a bit from the rice that was prepared for her child,
mm-hmm.
for her daughter. So she took a bit from that pile of rice.
And water.
And she gave water.
Yeah, so I have, having given a little of the rice prepared for her daughter to the beggar oppressed by hunger,
mm-hmm.
the woman gave it and water.
So you're having an implied object.
Yeah.
Interesting. I mean, I'd be fine with that as a fluent translation. As a literal translation, it's not there. But as a fluent translation, that's fine. Anyway, I think it's time to call the Pali class to an end.